I'm going to put my malicious hat on and try to attack my site to demo the new Vercel firewall. So on the right, I've got my terminal running, sending about 50 requests per second to my site, just using a tool called Plow. On the left, I've got the firewall, and I'm starting to notice some strange traffic. It looks like we're seeing a bunch of requests coming from this one IP address. Well, maybe I don't know exactly what's going wrong, so I'm just going to turn on attack challenge mode. Seems like things are under attack. I'm going to turn this on, and then instantly you're going to see on the left, the 200 status codes stop, and we start to see the 400 status codes. So now we're serving up this challenge page to all visitors, both non-human and human. So if I go over to my site, I reload the page, I see this Vercel security checkpoint, this challenge screen that's verifying that I'm a legit person. So I pass that, and then I'm able to continue using the site just normally, but we're still blocking all of this other non-human traffic over here in the terminal. So I've temporarily paused it, but I actually want to stop this at the root. So there was this IP address that this seems like the problem. So let's take this IP address. We can go in here. We can add a new rule, a new custom rule for our firewall. And we're going to block by IP. So we can go in here. We can find the IP address. If it equals this number, then we're going to, well, we could challenge it. You know what? Let's block it. Let's deny it. So I'll save this. I'll publish these changes. And if I go back here now, let me turn off attack challenge mode. So I'm going to turn this off. All right. And let me just get up to date here. Okay. So now we've turned off attack challenge mode and we have blocked traffic by an IP address. So you'll notice that we're still seeing the 400s come in over here on the right. And we see our challenge mode traffic here is on the yellow. But what happens if I go and visit the site directly? So I'm blocked in my browser as well as in the terminal because we're on the same IP address. And this can happen a lot if you do IP blocking on a shared space like a college or university campus. Ideally, you want to be a little bit more sophisticated rather than just the IP address. So I don't want to block the whole IP. I just want to block the malicious actor over here on the right. So maybe we can do a little bit better than that. Let's click on this traffic. Let's drill it in a little bit. Well, there's this user agent for Plow, which is actually what I'm using in my terminal here. So let's block that instead. Let's go to configure. We can click on this. And rather than block by IP, let's do block by user agent. I'll pick user agent. And if it equals Plow, then we'll block it. So review these changes. Publish these globally and propagate these in about 300 milliseconds, which is awesome. So we see these are still being blocked. No good traffic is getting through. But if I go back to here, I'm unblocked. Okay, so now we're only blocking the bad actor over here on the right, and we're not blocking the legitimate traffic, me, the human is trying to visit my site. But what if I told you that you could fake the user agents? What if I told you that people do this pretty commonly, actually. So let's say I stop this attack temporarily, and instead, I'm going to start sending a user agent that says, I'm not Plow. I'm the Go HTTP client, right? I'm doing this differently. Well, now, all of a sudden, look at that. We have 200 requests going again. So this is a pretty common attack pattern, is where people will just change up the IPs. They'll change up the user agents. They're going to try to send as much traffic as possible to confuse your system so that you can't prevent that user from accessing the site. So sure, I could now go back in here and I can see, okay, Go HTTP client had about 5 count here. We're going to let this traffic start to roll in live and see what it looks like. If we go back here, we see most of this was coming from Plow. What we're going to want to do is instead filter by something more specific than just the user agent. So we've got the Plow traffic here, but then over here, what is this? Go HTTP client. So they're coming at me from a different angle. I want to block this as well too. Well, let's filter by something else. What if we could filter by a unique fingerprint? So let's do this JA4 digest. Well, interesting. The same pattern here for Plow was the same pattern here with this Go HTTP client. Well, I think this is that malicious actor. I think this is the person or the bot that I want to block and not not the specific user agent. So let's get more specific. Let's block by JA4 instead. So let me click into this rule. We'll do block by JA4. I'm trying to move quick. They're racking up my requests. So if JA4 equals this, we're going to deny it, save, publish, block. Okay, there we go. All right, so now we're starting to see the 400s roll in. We've successfully stopped this malicious actor across multiple different user agents. So I can now rest peacefully. But what if we didn't want to just completely outright stop this? What if we wanted to let some traffic in, but not all of the traffic instead? Well, we also have the ability in our custom rules to be able to define rate limits. So maybe, for example, I want to say if any traffic comes to our entry path here, or maybe some API path, instead, rather than blocking based on that JA4, let's do a rate limit. Let's allow, let's call it 10 requests through every 5 seconds, and we're going to rate limit by the JA4. And we could also rate limit based on the IP address as well too. So let's set this up. Let's hit save. We'll publish this change. And now watch the 200 count. So we're at 5,066. Well, now we're at 5,076. And then another 5 seconds passes. And now we're at 5,086. So with just one custom rule in our firewall, we can now set up pretty complex rate limiting rules to only allow in some of our traffic. And this is just the start of all the different rules that are possible here. There's request path, method, user agent, query parameters, cookies, different regions, continent, state, city, AS numbers. Like there's a lot of different things here that we can dig into, but this was just a quick overview of how it works and a quick demo of me trying to take down my site. It looks like I stopped about, 15,000 malicious requests here. And let's see what this looks like back on my overview. All right, kind of a fun graph here. We've got our default legit web traffic that was happening before we stopped anything. Then we started to serve some challenges. Okay, then we were blocking by JA4, we were denying. Then over here, we were allowing traffic again. And then we set up this rate limit rule instead. So pretty nice that I can just visualize all of this from the dashboard. And that's the firewall. Okay, so with the demo, you've seen how it works. Now I want to take a little bit of a step back just to talk more conceptually about the traffic that's actually coming to your site. And I'm going to use the OSI model for the different layers of our network cake. If you haven't checked it out before, there's plenty of good content online. I'm just going to briefly touch on some of this. These things go very, very in depth. But I want to walk through coming from a request. You go to a browser, you type in a website, all the way to that response at the end, and show a couple of the different layers of the networking cake. So the first layer of the stack here is the application layer, or L7. This is when you see malicious actors try to access resources like /wp-admin or WordPress resources when I have a React app. So obviously I don't have that stuff. Or they try to do a path enumeration attack for a bunch of unknown or non-existent routes in my application. So happening kind of at that application layer. But this diagram, there's layers to it. There's levels to it. So let me just reveal back some of the complexity here. So then if we go down a little bit, you also have the transport layer. This is when you would see attacks coming at the protocol level. So something like a SYN flood. There's also more information about that online if you want to dig into it. Going even further, going down to the network layer. This is at the L3 is when you're going to target specific IPs. You'll notice most of the line items in here are talking about IPs. And then revealing all of the layers of the cake, we actually have the data layer or the physical layer when there's actual bits over wires, right? So going from left to right, I go to the browser, I type in acme.com. There's some DNS resolution. There's a TCP handshake. It goes and connects to the server. We have an SSL and TLS encryption stage where it goes across multiple layers of the OSI stack. This next step, which is important, is that we're creating a JA4 fingerprint. This is a relatively new way of actually taking that SSL TLS information, analyzing it, and making that unique fingerprint that we can use to identify and block malicious actors like we showed in the demo. So that's really powerful and it's available for free on all Vercel plans. Then we make that request from the browser to the server, again, going across all the layers of the stack. The server does some work, produces a response, and sends it back up to the browser where we can now see acme.com. The browser takes over and is able to parse and evaluate the scripts and do the rest of the work in the browser. So all parts of the stack are important here when thinking about protecting our application and preventing against malicious actors. Vercel's firewall is going to automatically protect you across L7, L4, L3 at Vercel's infrastructure layer. But with custom rules, you have the ability to then go in and define rules that are commonly against the L7 layer. So folks trying to attack by user agent or trying to, you know, go to a specific route or a specific target path, you have the ability to have more control over how that traffic is allowed or denied into your site. When you're making custom rules, there's quite a few options here you can choose from in terms of what you want your if block to contain, the different values like request path or location. We have a full list of all the different parameters in our documentation. The one that's, I think, really interesting is the target path. This is something that's kind of unique for Vercel because we have this framework awareness of the code you're writing. We call this framework defined infrastructure. So you can see, for example, if I'm making a bunch of random requests to random routes that don't exist, we can know that the framework route for that is /404 and target that directly. So a bunch of different parameters here, but then also you have all these different operators: equals, contains, does not contains, matches expressions. So looking at a regex, going back into here, you have all these different options as well too. Starts with, ends with, matches expression, whole bunch of things you can configure here. And then log, deny, challenge, and we'll soon have rate limit rolled out to all customers as well too. So there's a lot of flexibility with how you can create your custom rules, and we would love to hear from you what functionality you'd like to see us add to the firewall and what use cases you would like to use this for. It's also worth mentioning that if you publish a change and it was a mistake, you can go into the activity for your firewall and go back and restore to any version in time and do an instant rollback in the same amount of time it takes for you to propagate a change, which is about 300 milliseconds. So you have a lot of flexibility for how you create your rules, how you update your rules, and roll back your rules if necessary. All right, so that wraps up this video on the new Vercel firewall. You now have this brand new dashboard experience where you can see how Vercel is protecting you against malicious traffic and DDoS attacks, as well as the ability to set up custom rules to log, block, challenge, and soon rate limit traffic based on the fields that you want. This is free and available on all Vercel plans, so we'd love to hear your feedback. We also will have managed rule sets that you can purchase, with the first being protection from the OWASP top 10 rules for enterprise customers, but more coming on managed rule sets in the future. In the meantime, if you have feedback, please let us know what you'd like to see us build in the comments below, and we will get back to you. Peace.